So, good day, class. So, for today's topic, we will discuss inventories. Okay, so this is the introduction for inventories. So, the standard applies for inventories is PASTO or Philippine Accounting Standard 2. So, according to PASTO, it states that inventories are assets held for sale in the ordinary course of business in the process of production for such sale or in the form of materials or supplies to be consumed in the production process or in the rendering of services. So by definition itself, inventories is asset that held for sale in the ordinary course of business. Therefore, di ba, it's part of the operating cycle of the company na money lang normal binabaligya, di ba? So we only consider items as inventory if items are sold in the ordinary course of the business. So here we have definition of merchandising concern at the same time process of production. This is for manufacturing, diba? Because or supplies to be consumed in the production process. So this is part this is the manufacturing type of business wherein you need raw materials, diba? You need the labor cost, you need overhead in order to have a finished goods. Okay, so also, under PASTO, di ba, inventories is presented in the financial statement under statement of financial position as part of your current asset. So, one line item under current asset. Okay, so what are the important points that we need to consider under inventories? Okay, so as a rule, all goods to which the entity has title or ownership shall be included in the inventory account regardless of location. So, importante dire guys is ang title or ang ownership, who owns the goods, diba, to be included in the inventory item, diba, regardless of location. So, it does not mean na, wala sa imong lugar, you don't own the inventory. So, ang pinaka-importante dire is the title. So, who owns the inventory? Okay, so, also, take note that ownership is not the same with possession. Diba? Because there are some cases na you own the goods pero wala sa imong mga kamot ang goods. Diba? So, regardless of location, example, nasa other places or nasa you have other companies in other places, so the goods to adicto, not on your possession, but you are still the owner of the goods. So, pinaka-importante lang din, guys, is ang title. So, kinsa ang naay ownership sa goods para ma-appeal siya, ma-record sa as part of your inventory. Okay. So, this is what we call legal test. Okay. Maningitawag na ito nga legal test. So, legal test, who really owns the title of the goods. Okay. So, basically, ang atong button lang dire, identify kinsa ang owner sa goods, di ba? So, in answering inventories problem, kinahanglan nato i-consider ka kinsa tanga point of view. If kita ba si seller or kita ba si buyer? Because that's very important in answering the problems. So, we need to identify first kinsa tanga point of view, seller ba ta or buyer. So, these are the items or goods to be included as inventory. So, kaninga mga items, money ang pwede ma-appeal sa imong inventory. So, depende on which perspective ta, point of view. So, buyer bar seller. So, first item you have, okay, goods owned and on hand. Siyempre, di ba, that's part of our goods. If we own the goods, the same time, that's on hand, di ba? On our own possession, di ba? So, we have the title and the goods is, goods are under our possession. So, that's part of your inventory. Second is goods in transit and sold FOB destination or FOB buyer. So, take note, this is goods in transit. It means, di ba, the goods is still in transit. So, gibiyahe pa ang goods. Okay. And sold FOB destination. So, take note that sold. Therefore, we are the seller on this part, di ba? So, if we sell the goods, tapos ang term na to FOB destination or another term for FOB destination, that's FOB buyer. Take note of that, FOB buyer. So, if in transit siya and we are the seller, tapos ang shipping terms na to is FOB destination. Therefore, as a seller, kita gyapon ng owner sa goods. Diba? So FOB destination, sold FOB destination. Okay, later we'll explain FOB destination. I know, kabalo na mo ani because diba, we have already discussed this sa your basic in your basic accounting. Okay, that's the second item. Take note, we are the seller. Okay, so ang POV nato dire is seller. Okay. Next is goods in transit. Still, the goods are in transit. And purchase, take note, purchase. Therefore, if may tag-purchase, we are on the point of view of the buyer. So, purchase, so, in transit, and the shipping terms is FOB shipping point. Okay, that's FOB shipping point. So, the third to be included in our inventory is in transit ang goods, nag-travel siya, but we purchase the goods. So, kita dire, point of view, buyer. Okay, so we are the buyer here, di ba? So, we are the buyer, we purchase the goods, tapos in transit siya, then the shipping terms is FOB shipping point or FOB seller. So, if we are the buyer, tapos the goods are in transit, tapos the freight term is FOB shipping point, then the buyer owns the inventory. Okay, the buyer owns the goods while in transit pa siya. Okay, the fourth item is you have goods out on consignment. So, what is consignment? Under consignment, so we have two parties here. We have the consignor and the consignee. So, here, we are the consignor. Okay, we are the consignor. Okay, so, unsa nang consignment, sir? So, consignment, so this is very example. Diba, during your elementary days, you have canteens, diba? There are some, like, puta na to, consignor, kanang mga consignor, mana sila ang magbilin lang sa canteen, like ice candy, ibilin sa canteen ang ice candy, tapos si canteen na ang mubaligya. Then, pagkahapon, kolektahon ra ni consignor, pilay na hali ni canteen. Tapos, nalay share si canteen. So, ina na siya. So, goods out on consignment. So, we are on the perspective of the consignor. So, kung kita si consignor, kita ang nagbilin sa goods, sa canteen, still we are the owner of the inventory, of the ice candy. But, the possession na kang canteen. Diba? So, still it's part of our inventory if under consignment, out on consignment. So, take note that our point of view here is kita si consignor, not the consignee. Diba? So, because the consignor, although the possession of the goods, wala kang consignor, but the ownership, the title of the goods is still on the consignor. That's why it is included in the inventory. Okay. So, next is goods in the hands of salesmen or agents. Okay. So, basically, still, the possession wala sa imo, but the title or the ownership is still yours. Diba? Ikaw, gyapon. Imo lang siyang gipabaligya sa imong salesman or agent, but the owner of the goods is still the principal or kinsa tong tag-iya sa company, for example. Okay, so next is goods held by customer on approval or trial. So, dire kita si seller dire, 'di ba? Our point of view, we are the seller because 'di ba held by customer. So, 'di ba nasa kamot sa tong mga customer, but the goods, 'di ba, under the possession of our customer is on approval or on trial. Like for example, 'di ba? Sige, i-try sa ni customer for 1 week, 'di ba? On approval or trial for trial period, 'di ba? So after 1 week, if okay na, then that's the time ma-transfer ang title. But between the period of 1 week on approval or on trial, still the owner of the goods is the seller. So the point of view here is seller. Or pwede po sa buyer, di ba? If malapas na sa approval or trial period. Okay, so this from A to F, okay, this is considered as the legal test, di ba? So who has the title of the goods, di ba? Part sa iyang inventory. But the kining G item, which is goods purchased on installment, this is an example of substance over form. concept, di ba? Although under a sale or installment transaction, di ba? So the title, the ownership of the goods is not transferred to the buyer, not unless ma-fully pay niya ang total amount, di ba? Because installment siya, ma-fully pay niya. But with the concept of substance over form, di ba? The title is not yet transferred because naka-installment siya, wala pa na fully paid, but in substance, the title has already transferred, di ba? On the part of the buyer. So that's why here, our point of view here is the buyer. Di ba? Kita si buyer dire. So, goods purchase man, di ba? Purchase on installment. So, kung nagpalit ta on installment basis, nagpalit ta goods on installment basis, then the inventory is already considered or the items or the goods is already part of our inventory if we are the buyer, if we are the purchaser. But on the part of the seller, if the seller sell the goods on installment basis, so from the time of sale, diba, that's not part or that's not included on your inventory if you are the seller. Because again, this is the application of substance over form, although at form, the title has not yet transferred because naka-installment siya, but in substance, diba, there is already transfer of title. Okay. So this is kumbaga exemption sa legal test na to, di ba nga, and katong ownership gyud kinsa gyud ang nag-own sa goods. Okay, so let's proceed with the freight terms. So there are different freight terms that we need to consider in inventory transactions. So first, you have the FOB destination. Okay, what do you mean by FOB destination? So FOB destination, seller should pay the freight. So balik-balik na ni nato, di ba, sa itong basic accounting for those students na under sako. Say FOB destination, kinsa ang dapat magbayad sa freight. Okay. So again, si seller ang magbayad dapat sa freight pag FOB destination. Also, FOB destination, since you are on the inventory topic, di ba, we need to consider kinsa tag iya. Who has the title of the inventory, di ba? Okay, so FOB destination, the title of the goods is transferred upon receipt of the goods by the buyer at the point of destination. Therefore, if the shipping terms is FOB destination, si seller dapat magbayad sa freight and the title of the goods is transferred upon receipt. Diba? Pag madawat na ni buyer ang goods, asa pa matransfer ang title. Diba? At the point of destination. Mangita ko sa FOB destination. Pag moabot na ang goods sa iyang destination or kang buyer or upon receipt of the buyer, that's the time na transfer ang title. That's why kagaina, dire sa letter B nga item, diba? Goods in transit and sold FOB destination. Why? Because while the goods are still in transit, tapos ang kita si seller, tapos diba, gibaligya nato ang goods na in transit pa, nagbiyahe pa padulong kang buyer, tapos ang shipping terms is FOB destination. So still, si seller gapon ang owner sa goods. Why? Because diba, FOB destination, the title transferred upon receipt, upon reaching to the destination. Okay. So, FOB destination. Again, si seller dapat magbayad sa freight and the title of the goods is transferred upon receipt of the goods by the buyer at the point of destination. Next, we have FOB shipping point. What do you mean by FOB shipping point? So, buyer should pay the freight. Si buyer dapat ang magbayad sa freight, di ba? Okay, si buyer dapat ang magbayad sa freight. The title, how about the title of the goods, di ba? So, kanusa ma-transfer ang title sa goods pag FOB shipping point? Okay, the title of the goods is transferred upon shipment of the goods, di ba? Because FOB shipping point. Therefore, the title is transferred to the buyer upon shipment. Pagpadala. pag-pick up sa career or pagpadala sa career. Okay, pag-ship ni mo, di ba? Therefore, upon shipment, transfer the untitled, di ba? Pag FOB shipping point. That's why on letter C here, item C, di ba? Purchase man ang gigamit niya. Therefore, we are the buyer here, di ba? Our point of view is the buyer. Therefore, kung nagpalit ta o goods, tapos nagbiyahe pa siya, niya ang freight term niya, shipping term niya, shipping point, di ba? The title is transferred upon shipment. So pagpadala sa seller, kita ni tag iya ana while nagbiyahe na siya. We are the owner already of the goods while in transit siya. Okay. Next, you have freight collect. What do you mean by freight collect? Diba? Actually, the freight collect, this freight charge is actually paid by the buyer. So, kanyang freight collect, muna ang itong ginatawag, kinsa ang nagbayad. Kinsa ang nagbayad sa freight. Diba? So, when you say freight collect, kinsa ang nagbayad sa freight. So, that's si buyer ang nagbayad sa freight. So, again, pag may tag freight collect, kinsa ang nagbayad. Kinsa ang nagbayad. Okay, so actually, pag freight collect, freight charge is actually paid by the buyer. So, si buyer ang nagbayad pag freight collect. How about freight prepaid? Freight prepaid, okay, kinsa ang nagbayad sa freight, di ba? So, kinsa ang actual nagbayad sa freight? So, the freight is actually paid by the seller. So, seller ang nagbayad. Okay. So, other, we also have maritime mga shipping terms, di ba? So, we have free alongside or FAS. What will happen here? Okay, what will happen here sa free alongside, di ba? Natin gitawad na, so, a seller who ships FAS must bear all expenses and risk involved in delivering the goods to the dock next to or alongside the vessel on which goods are to be shipped. So, the question now is, kano sa matransfer ang title pag free alongside siya? Okay, so, the buyer bears the cost of loading and shipment and thus, the title passes to the buyer when the carrier takes possession of the goods. Okay, so, in anima itabo sa free alongside? Si seller, iyang gipadala sa pantalan. Diba? So, gikan pagpadala ni seller padulong sa pantalan, kasi owner sa goods, si seller pa. But, gikan sa pantalan, once isakay na ang goods sa carrier, therefore, the title transferred to the buyer. Diba? Pag-transfer sa carrier, sa goods. Diba? So, you say free alongside, while gihatod pa ni seller sa pantalan, sa dock, okay, seller pa ang owner sa goods. But upon transfer from dock to the carrier, gisakay na sa, for example, sa kukalyong, okay, si buyer na ang owner sa goods. Therefore, the title is already transferred. Okay, upon transfer to the carrier, di ba? So, when the carrier takes possession of the goods. Therefore, the title of the goods transferred to the buyer when the goods is in the possession of the carrier na. But in this part pa nga gihatod pa sa dock sa pantalan, once wala pa nasakay sa carrier, then si seller pa ang owner sa goods. That's free alongside. How about CIF? Cost, insurance, and freight. Title is transferred upon delivery of the goods to the carrier. So therefore, ang title is transferred upon delivery of the goods to the carrier. Same lang sa free alongside, di ba? Okay, medyo same lang siya. Once to na sa carrier, then that's the time nga matransfer ang title kang buyer. How about ex-ship? So, the title is transferred when the goods are unloaded. Okay, so, ang tabo dire, pag ex-ship siya, title is transferred when the goods are unloaded. Matransfer lang ang title pag i-unload na ang mga goods. Kumbaga, gidiskarga na ang goods from the carrier. Diba, ginaog na sa pantalan. Diba? So, gikan sa barko, gi-unload na siya sa pantalan. So, that's the time that the title of the goods transferred to the buyer. So mo nang gitawag nga exship. Okay. So just a review from your basic accounting, di ba? We have pwede i-combine ang mga freight terms, especially kaning destination and freight collect, di ba? Kaning mga freight collect, freight prepaid, FOB destination, FOB shipping point. Okay, example, na pwede sa i-combine like ani, FOB destination, freight prepaid, di ba? Kung may tag destination or shipping point, kinsa ang dapat magbayad sa freight? Kung may tag freight collect, freight prepaid, kinsa ang actual nagbayad, di ba, sa freight? Okay, in this case, FOB destination, kinsa dapat ang magbayad? Si seller, because destination siya. Pag may tag freight prepaid, kinsa ang nagbayad sa freight? Pag prepaid, si seller gyapon, di ba? So, what is the journal entry, di ba? So, we have two point of view here. We have on the seller's point of view and buyer's point of view. Okay. So, in this case, kung inani ang freight terms niya, FOB destination, freight prepaid, si seller ang dapat magbayad, si seller ang nagbayad. So, tama ra, di ba? Tama ra nga si seller ang dapat magbayad, siya gid po'y nagbayad. So, what is the entry? Di ba? What is the entry on the point of view of the seller? So, the answer is debit freight out or selling expenses, then credit cash. Because again, di ba, siya ang nagbayad, actual nagbayad because freight prepaid. So, naka-cash siya. Tapos, naka-freight out siya because, di ba, FOB destination. Kumbaga, morning gibayad ni seller upon shipment, para shipping fee para sa goods, di ba, na iyang gipadala. So, freight out siya. Okay. On buyer's point of view, naibay gibuhat si buyer, wala, di ba? Because, di ba, destination, si seller dapat ang magbayad, tapos, kinsa ang actual nagbayad? Si seller rapod ang actual nagbayad. So, sa point of view ni buyer, wala sa ibuhaton nga entry. Di ba? Okay, for this transaction. Next, what if FOB destination, freight collect, di ba? So, FOB destination, dapat si seller ang magbayad, but because freight collect, kinsa ang actual nagbayad? Si buyer, di ba? So, kaninga term, si seller dapat ang magbayad, pero si buyer ang nagbayad. So, unsay may tabo? Di ba? So, sa seller's point of view, di ba? Seller's point of view, sinaning may tabo? Di ba? Because kinsa dapat ang magbayad? Si seller. That's why na-i freight out. Diba? Nag-record tag freight out kang seller because again, seller will only record freight out if the shipping term is FOB destination. Take note of that, diba? So, mo record lang tag freight out under seller's point of view if the shipping term is FOB destination. That's why na I freight out diri because destination on the second case, diba? Freight out gyapon because na destination. Okay. But freight collect siya. Diba? So, wala tayo i-credit nga cash. Again, dili man si seller ang actual nagbayad. Siya lang dapat ang mubayad, pero si buyer ang nagbayad. So, unsay nahitabo? Diba? So, unsay nahitabo ani? Okay. So, basically, ang nahitabo ani, since, buyer, sa point of view ni seller, buyer, ako ang dapat magbayad buyer, pero ikaw man ang nagbayad buyer. Therefore, ang akong kolektahon nun sa imo, i-minus na lang tong freight nga imong gibayad. That's why may tabo, nag-credit ta og accounts receivable. Okay, nag-credit ta og accounts receivable. Okay, sa part po ni buyer, di ba, freight collect man siya, therefore, si buyer ang nagbayad. That's why na-ay cash. Di ba, na-ay cash dire. Okay, so na-ay cash. Sige, credit ang cash because si buyer man ang bayad. Pero kinsa dapat ang magbayad? Si seller ang dapat magbayad. So, ang sige buhat ni buyer, oy seller, ikaw man ang dapat magbayad sa freight. Pero ako, ikaw dapat magbayad sa freight, pero ako na lang sang gibayaran seller. Therefore, kauan ako ang akong bayronon sa imo. Diba? So, akong bawasan ang akong accounts payable sa imo because ikaw man dapat magbayad sa freight, pero ako'y nagbayad. So ako na lang i-deduct sa kung bayro nun sa imo. So mo nang ingon ni buyer, di ba? Mo nang ingon ni buyer. Okay. So next, you have FOB shipping point and freight collect. Okay, FOB shipping point, kinsa dapat ang magbayad? So FOB shipping point, kinsa ang dapat magbayad? Si buyer because shipping point. Freight collect, kinsa ang actual nagbayad sa freight? Si buyer gapon. Therefore, wala tay buhaton kang seller because wa may gibuhat si seller diri, di ba? Because si buyer dapat ang magbayad, tapos si buyer pud ang nagbayad. So wala tay entry regarding the kaning sa freight nato nga transaction. It is only for the freight transaction sa okay. So on the buyer's point of view, di ba? Si buyer dapat magbayad, siya po'y nagbayad. So therefore, that's why nag-credit ta because siya, nag-credit ang cash because siya ang actual nagbayad. So that's credit cash. And take note that, di ba, on buyer's point of view, if naka-shipping point siya, we account the transportation as freight in. So naka-freight in siya. So we only record freight in on the buyer's point of view if the freight term or shipping term is shipping point. Pag shipping point gani, tapos ikaw si buyer, that's the time you record freight in. Okay, so that's why freight in, because siya dapat ang magbayad. Okay, then we credit cash because siya ang actual nagbayad because freight collect. Okay, how about FOB shipping point, freight prepaid. FOB shipping point, kinsa dapat ang magbayad? Si buyer because naka-shipping point. Pero freight prepaid ban, kinsa ang actual nagbayad sa freight? Si seller, di ba? Freight prepaid. So, si button ni seller, sa point of view ni seller, di ba siya ang nagbayad? That's why nasa credit cash. Because ako'y nagbayad buyer. Dapat ikaw ang magbayad, pero ako'y nagbayad. Because kay ikaw dapat ang magbayad buyer, pero akong gibayaran ang freight, dungagan ako ang akong dawatunon sa imo. Dungagan ako ang accounts receivable ng akong dawatunon sa imo. Diba? Because ikaw dapat magbayad sa freight, pero ako na lang nagbayad sa freight. Therefore, akong idungagan ang akong dawatonon sa imo kay nagbayad ko sa freight. So, possibly dapat ikaw ang dapat magbayad sa freight. Okay, sa part po ni buyer, since naka-shipping point, ang freight term shipping point, nag-record siya og freight in. That's part of the transportation is accounted as freight in. Oy seller, ingon si buyer, seller, ako man dapat magbayad pero gibayaran man nimo ang freight, di ba? Sige ani na lang, ako na lang dungaga ng akong bayro noon sa imo. Di ba? So ako na lang dungagan ang bayro noon nako sa imo, seller, because ako dapat magbayad sa freight pero ikaw may nibayad sa freight. So ako na lang dungagan ang akong bayro noon sa imo. Okay, so bantay lang ninyo guys, pinaka-importante dire, you need to consider kinsa ka nga point of view, di ba? So, under seller's point of view, we only record freight out if the shipping term is destination, di ba? In this case, destination ang first, natay freight out. Second, destination, natay freight out. But, pag shipping point na, wala. Wala nag-record og freight out. Pag shipping point na, wala ta nag-record og freight out. On the part of the buyer, buyer's point of view, diba, we only record freight in if ang shipping term is shipping point. Diba? Shipping point na ay freight in. Shipping point na ay freight in. But pag destination, wala. Wala tayong record nga transportation cost. Pag destination, wala tayong record nga transportation cost. Okay. So, review lang to siya from your basic accounting. Okay, so let's proceed with the accounting of inventories. Diba? Under your basic accounting, we have two systems in accounting for inventories or merchandising concern. You have the periodic inventory system and you have the perpetual inventory system. Okay, what's the difference between periodic inventory system and perpetual inventory system? Under periodic inventory system, diba, we only count the goods at the end of the period. Periodic lang, diba? Nag-iihap lang ta, nag-physical count ta at the end of the period, diba? It's either monthly or semi-annual or annually, di ba? So nagaihap ta sa inventory. That's periodic inventory system. While perpetual inventory system, di ba? So updated atong inventory account by using stock cards. So we are using your stock cards, di ba? So updated sa kada adlaw, di ba? At the end of the day, updated imong inventory account, di ba? So perpetual by using stock cards. Example, karon naatay stock na pulo ka ballpen, na inipalit duha, so at the end of the day, pila'y nabilin. So, kinala ni mo sa i-update always ang stock card ni mo for that item. Diba? So, perpetual inventory system. Okay. Periodic inventory system, normally, mas practical sa gamiton for those inventories nga high value. Dagkog amount, like for example, mga sakyanan, diba? Ginagmay raman ang sakyanan at the same time, When we are using periodic inventory system, this is applicable for those, low value or low cost inventories. Like for example, sa grocery stores, di ba? So, sabon, di ba? Ang sabon, daghan kaayo. Tapos, dili po na nakadako ang value niya. That's why, mas practical, gamiton ang periodic inventory system. Kay kapoy, kung kadaadlaw, mag-ihap mo sa sabon. Di ba? So, kung perpetualo ni mo siya. Diba? So normally periodic inventory system mas practical sa gamiton for those entities na ang ilang inventory items are low cost, 'di ba? Or low value inventories. Like sa groceries, 'di ba? Ina siya hardwares, 'di ba? So mas practical gamiton ang periodic inventory system. Why? Because again, at the end of the month lang mo mag-count or periodic every year lang mo mag-count. While under perpetual inventory system, this is practical gamiton sa mga inventories nga high value, high cost nga mga inventories. Example, mga kanang sa mga sakyanan, di ba? Like Kia, mga Suzuki, Yamaha, di ba? Inaana siya. Di ba? Ang ilang inventory mahal, di ba? Dagko og value ang mga sakyanan. At the same time, dili sa inana kadaghan ang sakyanan, di ba? Kaya ra nimo maihap. Kay dili man kada adlaw or siguro kada that's very good kung kada adlaw na mahaling nga sakyanan, di ba? Inaana siya. Pero dali na nimo ma-monitor, di ba? So, mas practical gamiton ang perpetual inventory system. But actually, with the use of technology, even mga grocery stores, with the help of mga accounting systems, di ba? Computers and accounting system, accounting softwares na available karon sa market, with the help of the technology, even kato mga low value or low cost ng mga inventories, nagagamit na silang perpetual inventory system because of technology, because of accounting softwares na ginagamit, di ba? Like for example, kanang mga grocery stores, ginagamit nga system nga every time na ay mahalin, automatic mo update siya. Okay, example ana, so we have accounting system like SISAP, di ba? SAP. So, naka-perpetual ang inventory system ni SAP. So, nindot siya because for example, naakay ka ng school supplies, lalay mo na ang item ng red ball pen, 0.5, my gel, black ball pen, 0.3. So, isa na siya ka-inventory item. And if you're using accounting system, once ma-punch siya, di ba, automatic, mo-update ng imong numbers of inventories. Di ba? So, with the use of technology. But if medyo ang store wala pa enough capital for kanang accounting information, for accounting software, so periodic lang sa yun. Diba? So, ihap lang mo at end of the month, diba? Inana siya. Okay. At the same time, the difference between the two, periodic and perpetual inventory system, diba? Accounts nga itong ginagamit, diba? We have accounts nga sa periodic lang ito ginagamit. At the same time, we have accounts nga sa perpetual inventory system lang ito ginagamit. And under periodic inventory system, diba? We use the account purchases, purchase returns, diba? Freight in. Diba? So, ginagamit na ito ni sila ng mga accounts. Okay, under periodic inventory system. While sa perpetual inventory system, so we don't use these accounts to mga purchases, purchase returns, freight in. Okay, but we use the account cost of sale and merchandise inventory account. Diba? Cost of sale can be computed immediately based on the entries. Diba? At the same time, in the computation of cost of sale under periodic inventory system, we need to follow the formula. Diba? That's beginning inventory plus net purchases, that is your goods available for sale, then less ending inventory, that is your cost of sale. But under perpetual inventory system, again, because, di ba, from time to time, there's in and out of the goods updated siya. You update every time na ay nisunod nga inventory, and you update every time there's a sale of inventory. So, you can compute immediately the cost of sale, di ba? So, based on the in and out of the inventories. Okay, so that's our accounting for inventories, di ba? You have periodic inventory system and perpetual inventory system. Again, periodic inventory system, you only count the goods on a periodic basis. Example, at the end of the month lang, semi-annual ba, or at the end of the year. Under perpetual inventory system, your inventory account is updated. Di ba? Every time na nagpalit ka og inventory, gina-update ni mo by using stock cards. Every time na ay sale of inventory, di ba? Gina-update ni mo ang stock card. So, eventually, kung pangutan-on ka, how much is the inventory, makatubag yun ka under perpetual inventory system because updated ang imong stock card, updated ang imong inventory account. Also, under inventories, di ba, we have formulas. Okay, so this is also part of basic accounting under merchandising concern. So, we have the formula, di ba, to compute the invoice price, which is the cost of the inventory. Okay, so you have the list price. Okay, so list price minus trade discount, then that is your invoice price, di ba? So, list price minus trade discount equals invoice price minus cash discount, then that is the net amount, or this is the payable amount or a receivable amount. Okay, so list price, di ba, basically, price si Ausay, gina-post sa mga items, sa goods, tapos ginagahatag po na sa trade discount. Trade discount is just to encourage the sale, di ba, para ganahan mo palit ang mga tao, so ginatagan sila trade discount. By the way, trade discount is not accounted. Diba? Trade discount is ignored. Kumbaga, trade discount is not accounted or dili na to sa gina-entryhan. Diba? So, trade discount. So, wala tayo entry sa trade discount. But, we have entry for cash discount. Okay. But, how do we compute the cost of the inventory? Because, the initial measurement of the inventory is at cost, di ba? Okay, so how do we measure the inventory? So this is how we compute the cost of the inventory. So you have cost of purchase, you have cost of conversion, then you have other costs incurred that are necessary. Then that is the cost of the inventory. What is the composition of that cost of purchase? Unsay composition ani? So mao ni siya. So, you have purchase price, or basically, that is your list price because, di ba, naatay trade discount pa dere. So, purchase price or your list price, you have the import duties plus the import duties plus the irrecoverable taxes. Take note, irrecoverable taxes plus the freight. This is the freight in plus handling cost. Okay, that's same lang sa freight, di ba, na siya handling cost. Plus directly attributable cost minus trade discount and if na rebates minus the rebates. Rebates diba ka na murasag ka ng murasag po sa discount, diba? So deduct the rebates. Then that is the cost of the purchase or cost of your inventory. Diba? Cost of conversion, this is applicable for manufacturing concern companies, diba? Because you convert the materials, diba, into finished goods, diba? So, you incur materials, you have the labor, you have the overhead, then you come up with katong goods in process, diba? And finished goods. Okay. So, I guess this was already discussed in your cost accounting. So, our focus here, dili kayo ta focus on manufacturing concern. So, but still, part gapon sa inventory. Okay. So, other costs, unsay composition aning other costs? So, other costs incurred in bringing the inventories to their present condition. So, these are costs nga importante sa to bring the condition, to bring inventories to their present condition. So, example of this is storage cost. Take note of this. Storage cost of goods in process. Why? Diba? Importante si, kinalan yung kamugasag storage cost. It's part of the cost of the inventory. Ang storage cost On goods in process. Why? Di ba? In process pa man ang goods. Kay kung if dili nimo sa store ang goods, sin madaot, di na nun ma-convert into finished goods. Di ba? Di ba? So, kinangalan siya to bring to their present condition para mahimo siya ang finished goods. Di ba? Kinangalan nimo store ang goods in process. Okay, so therefore, storage cost on goods in process is part of the cost of the inventory. And these are the following costs or items that are expensed outright. Therefore, not capitalizable as part of your inventory, not part of cost of inventory. Therefore, expense outright, di ba? Expense nyo diretso. Okay, you have example, abnormal costs. You have storage costs on finished goods, di ba? Finished goods naman siya, di ba? So, pwede na sa mabaligya, di ba? So, therefore, the storage cost, dili na sa importante for their present condition, di ba? Murag, dili sa necessary to bring the inventory to their present condition because nahuman naman siya. Then, being a finished goods, pwede na sa mabaligya, ma-resell na siya. So, kung ginastore pa ang finished goods, that's not part of the cost of the inventory anymore, di ba? That's expense outright na. So, storage expense, di ba? Bana siya. Okay. Then, administrative overhead. Of course, di ba? Administrative overhead, not part of the cost of the inventory. Then, distribution or selling cost is freight out on your part as a seller, di ba? So, that's the time nga imong gina-distribute na ang goods, then that's not already part of the cost of the inventory. Di ba? So, that's already freight out or distribution or selling cost. So, I guess that's all for the inventories or the introduction of inventories. So, let's proceed with sample problems. So, again, ang importante sa inventory is who owns the inventory, di ba? Kakinsa ang title, kinsa ang na-title sa inventory regardless of the location or possession. So, atong ginatanaw diri, who owns the inventory? Who has a title to the goods, di ba? Not necessary kinsa ang na-possession sa goods, di ba? Na siya. Okay. So first, if ma-answer ito og problems ani, we need to be kanang particular sa mga wording sa problem. Especially if kana mga included, excluded, di ba? So, bantay yun na ninyo because, di ba, one word lang na sa pwede mo masayop. Di ba, sa yung answer. And before you answer, di ba, every line item, you need to consider kinsa ka nga point of view. If buyer ba ka, if seller ba ka on that transaction. Because again, maka-affect siya kung appeal ba ang inventory sa imo or dili. Okay, sige, let's answer sample problem number one. So, Hero Company reported inventory on December 31, 2019 at 6 million based on physical count of goods, price at cost, and before any necessary year-end adjustment relating to the following. So, sinaitabo, si Hero Company at the end of the year, December 31, 2019, nag-ihap siya sa iyang goods. Diba? Nag-physical count siya. So, nag-ihap siya sa iyang goods. Ang iyang na-ihap, nga price iyang goods at cost, is naka-ihap siya 6 million. Okay. So, naasay 6 million during physical count. Diba? Physical count. Okay, nasa 6M. Okay, so before any necessary year-end adjusting relating to the following. So, kani sila, pag-ihap niya 6 million, tapos naapa niya mga items, di ba? So, wala pa niya ni na-consider. Wala pa niya na-adjust ang kanang 6 million. So, we need to check if kani mga items, importante ba ni siya? Appeal ba ni siya sa ato or dili? So, muna yung bantayan na. Okay, so 6 million, iyang naihap, tapos wala pa niya na-adjust, napay duha ka items na bilin. Okay, first item is included, take note of that, included in the physical count were goods billed to a customer FOB shipping point on December 31, 2019. First, you need to identify kinsa ta nga point of view. So, kinsa ta nga point of view ani? So, di ba? included in the physical count were goods billed to a customer, pasabot gibill nato kang customer, therefore kinsa ta nga point of view. We are on the point of view of the seller. Kita si seller. Okay. So na-appeal daw nato ni, di ba? Na-appeal sa 6 million, na-appeal natog ihap ang kaninga inventory. Di nga atong gibill kang customer. Tapos ang shipping terms nato FOB shipping point on December 31, 2019. Take note, FOB shipping point, the title of the goods transferred upon shipment. Di ba? Upon shipment. Okay. So take note ha, upon shipment. Okay, these goods had a cost of 125,000 and were picked up by the carrier on January 10, 2020. Okay, so inani na itabo. Diba na-appeal sa iyang pag-ihap ang goods nga na ay cost nga 125,000. Question karon, kinsay tag-iha sa goods? Kinsay na title sa goods, si seller or ang buyer na? So, sa isa na ito, tanaw, di ba? Kita si seller na dire. Kita na si seller dire. Na-appeal na ito niya sa ito pag-ihap. Gibill na ito kang customer. Unsa ang freight term? FOB shipping point. Kung FOB shipping point, the title of the goods transferred upon shipment. So, the question now is, kanusa na ship ang goods? Because mo man na ang maka-identify, di ba? Kinsay tag-iya sa goods. Nga in transit, di ba? Because this is in transit goods. Okay, so FOB shipping point, di ba? The question is, kanong saan na-ship ang goods, ang inventory? Is it on December 31, 2019 or on January 10, 2020? Okay, so ato pang itaon dahil kanong saan na-ship? Okay, so ang sinaitabo sa December 31, 2019, giunsa raman, gisip ba niya? Wala, wala niya gisip, only billed. Nag-bill lang siya kang customer. But kanusa na ship ang products? Kanusa na ship ang goods? So the inventory is shipped when it was picked up by the carrier, di ba? Siyempre, di ba, gi-ship ni mo, so na kang carrier, gi-pick up ni carrier. So as upon shipment, upon pick up by the carrier. So kanusa gi-ship on January 10, 2020. Question, on December 31, 2019, kinsay owner sa goods? You say owner sa goods? Si seller. Why? Because, di ba? Although shipping point, pero the question is, kanusa na ship? January pa man na ship. Di ba? So, on December 31, 2019, kita gyapon ang owner sa goods. So, tama ba nga na-appeal? Gi-appeal na to sa atong physical count? Yes, tama ra nga na-appeal sa atong physical count. Therefore, on sa atong button ani nga item, we ignore. Di ba? Ignore the item. Why? Because na-include naman siya. Diba? It was already included in the physical count. So, tama ra nga na-appeal siya sa physical count. Okay. So, wala. Ignore the item. Diba? So, next is goods ship FOB shipping point on December 28, 2019 from a vendor to Hero Company were received on January 4, 2020. The invoice cost was 300,000. Oh, first, we need to identify kinsa tanga point of view. So, kinsa tanga point of view? So, we are the buyer. Diba? Why buyer? Because, again, from a vendor. Gipalit nato kang vendor. Diba? Gipalit ni Hero Company kang vendor. Therefore, we are the buyer. So, if we are the buyer, we need to consider the shipping terms. So, what is the shipping terms? That is FOB shipping point. FOB shipping point, the transfer of the goods, the title of the goods is transferred upon shipment. Question, kanusa na ship ang goods? Take note, goods ship FOB shipping point on December 28, 2019. Therefore, on December 28, 2019, na-ship na ang goods. Therefore, kinsa na'y owner sa goods? So, si buyer na. Kita na ang owner sa goods. Buyer is now the owner of the goods because the shipping terms is shipping point, which is the title transferred upon shipment, and the shipment happens on December 28, 2019. Although, na-receive na to January 4. But again, you under shipping point, di ba? The title of the goods transferred upon shipment. Therefore, na-transfer na sa ato upon shipment on December 28, 2019. We are now the owner of the goods. Question, na-appeal ba? Na-appeal ba na sa ato? Sa atong physical count? Ang 300,000 nga goods? Siyempre, wala. Why? Because in transit siya. Wala ni mo gi-appeal o gi-hap, di ba? Wala ni mo nakita na pag-ihap ni mo. So, therefore, i-appeal ba nato ni? Yes, dapat i-appeal ni siya. Therefore, plus 300,000. Therefore, this is item 2. Pila ni 300,000. Therefore, wala na line item. So, the total cost of inventory, total inventory to be reported on December 31, 2019 is 6.3 million. So this is the answer. Okay, that's the answer.